So now there's the coronavirus, but what we're seeing in the real estate market is interest rates at historic lows and the spring buying season, which is shortly upon us. The challenge for the housing market has really been a lack of supply, so we continue to see the number of homes for sale decline compared to a year ago. It's not that buyers can't afford homes, that's actually gotten easier this year. It's that they can't find homes to buy, and that still remains the chief challenge. So with rates so low, are we looking at some pretty big price increases on some of these homes? With limited options, it was already a very competitive market, but with low mortgage rates, it shifts the differential of who can compete more successfully. So previously, cash buyers were doing very well, which tends to be older buyers or investors. But now, with lower mortgage rates, it creates that boost of purchasing power of younger buyers who tend to finance more of a home purchase. So we may see them have more success in the market this year, even as prices pick back up and increase even faster. So with folks not leaving their homes, there are lots of places in the housing transaction where concerns about spreading virus might have a role, so you might see fewer people at open houses. There's a lot of in-person pieces of the transaction, but the good thing is technology enables more parts of the transaction to take place online or virtually. The interesting thing is that with rates at all-time lows, instead of staying put and refinancing, this opens up an opportunity for people who previously were locked into a really good mortgage rate to think about buying another home. It also really creates a lot of opportunity for those people. So whether you are already invested in real estate or you're thinking about it, the impact of the coronavirus has already been gigantic and it's growing more rapidly.